إن الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. الآداب العشرة The 10 codes of conduct were in 10th manner, which is clothing, were in 3rd lesson of that manner. Tonight, inshallah, we are talking about al-awrah, the private parts. The clothing, in the clothing, we want to talk about the private parts. Because it's important when you are wearing, to wear something covers your awrah. That's essential. So we start awratul rajuli, the private parts of the male. Of the male, how long, how much it is, and what is it? The male have two types of awrah. Awrah in the normal and awrah in the salah. Awrah in the normal, it has been agreed by all scholars. Awrah in the salah has not been agreed. It is sunnah or wajib. We'll see inshallah. Sahih Abi Dawood عن زرعة بن عبد الرحمن بن جرهد عن زرعة بن عبد الرحمن بن جرهد عن أبيه عبد الرحمن بن جرهد قال So he narrated the hadith from his father. Father said, كان جرهدون means the grandfather. So this is blessed family. Yeah. Grandfather, he taught his son, and the son taught his son. So that is where it comes the knowledge. Whatever you learn, pass to your family. Otherwise, you are not doing good in your knowledge. Yeah. Umm Salama, she said, when Abu Salama died, yeah, I read dua. And the dua, I learned from Abu Salama himself. So the companions, when they learn something, they pass to their wives. Otherwise, bring your wife into the masjid 5 times salah. So whatever you learn, pass to your wife, pass to your children. They will learn from that. If you don't pass any knowledge to your wife, you're not going to be sheikh for her. Although she's looking for other sheikh to ask. So what? What's your value in the family in that case? You can't lead your wife. Yeah. When it comes to salah, she knows more Quran than you. What you can do? When it comes to a fatwa, you know nothing. She's looking for another sheikh to ask. You need to learn and be leader in your family. So كان جرهدون هذا من أصحاب الصفة. He's one of the companions of the Sufa. Sufa is at the end of the masjid. Those companions who used to come to Mecca, Medina, and they don't have families, nowhere to go. They sleep at the back of the masjid. And the companions, when they are going to their dinner, they used to take one or two or three with them to have dinner. So the living was from dinner to dinner, nothing else. So he was one of the fuqara of the companions. What happened to him? He said, جَلَسَ عِنْدَنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم came and sat with us. There are poor people, أصحاب الصفة, they are sitting in there. So Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم building up their morale. Goes to them and he sits with them. That's how the Islam is. If you look, any person who was born or who afflicted by any calamity and you look him down, that means your iman is not strong enough. Yeah. You should build the moral and the iman of that people. So Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم used to go all the way to them and sit with them where they are sitting. He said, Jarhat, وفخذي منكشفة عن ماي ساي Yeah, was uncovered. It's hot water and they sit certain way. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أما علمت do you know أن الفخذ عورة the thigh is private part. I mean this, so allow it to show you thigh. And if someone shows, so allow it for you to watch the football. Come the problem here. Yes. You are watching the private parts. Yeah. So you are erring sin. In here, when you are sitting with people, you are one of two. You are more knowledgeable than them and you teach them. Or they are more knowledgeable than you, you learn from them. All others sitting and gathering and have no any value. Always either learn or teach. That's your duty. So Prophet ﷺ have seen something wrong and he told him. So when you see something wrong, you have right to tell the correct. But people normally they don't take from you, don't be upset. They don't take from you, don't be upset. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, him and the people, like he's holding the belt tight of the body, where the tight the belt. Yeah. They are falling to the hellfire and he's pulling them back from hellfire. And that's your duty. Yeah. Teach the people, pull them out of the hellfire. If they don't listen to you, don't be upset. وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. Yeah. They don't take from you. They turn away from you. They spit on your face. They say something abusive words to you. They can beat you. But that should not stop you. Yeah. Giving the da'wah to them. In the right manner. الجامع الصغير عن عبد الله بن جعفر بن أبي طالب رضي الله عنهما. Abdullah is a companion. His father, Ja'far, is a companion. His current father is not Muslim. So both Abdullah and Ja'far, and Huma, both of them. Abdullah and Huma. Qala, Qala Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ma bayna surrati wa rukba, as-surra, yes, wa rukba. Surra is the navel bottom. Yes. And the rukba is the knee. In between them, there's awra. That's the main awra of the person, is in between these two. There's another hadith. I don't want to bring all hadith in here for the time. Rukba is knee itself, it's not including the awra. Knee itself is not including. But above the knee, all the way to the belly button. That is the general aura of the man. General aura of the man. So there's another aura for the man, which is in the salah. First part of the male in the salah. We'll give, inshallah, three hadiths. Mutafiqun alayhi. عن عمر بن أبي سلمة رضي الله عنهما عمر بن أبي سلمة عمر بن أبي سلمة he is the son of أم سلمة وافد برسول صلى الله عليه وسلم من برسول صلى الله عليه وسلم married أم سلمة عمر was roughly 4 years and عمر narrated the main hadith for the eating يا بني كل مما يليك يا بني سمي الله وكل مما يليك وكل بيمينك because he shares the food with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم when the Prophet comes he eats with him so he eats with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and he's a young boy so Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم taught him the adab سمي الله say بسم الله when you start وكل مما يليك and eat from your side Don't come to other sides to take from there. Samillah, wa kulli bi yaminika wa kulli ma yalika. Also eat with your right hand. He was young at that time. So he said, Umar ibn Abi Salama, Ra'aytu Rasulallahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yusalli fi thawbin wahida. I've seen the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam praying with only one garment. One garment. Mushtamilan bihi, yeah. He tied it in himself. He bade to Umm Salama in the house of Umm Salama. That's his mom, his mother, Umm Salama. وَاضِعًا طَرَفَيْهِ عَلَى عَاتِقَيْهِ طَرَفَيْهِ عَلَى عَاتِقَيْهِ When he's wearing what he done, only one garment, he covered his private parts. Yeah. And then he pulled on the both sides. On the right side, on the left shoulder, on the left side, on the right shoulder, and he tied it in here. وَاضِعًا عَلَى عَاتِقَيْهِ The two sides was on the shoulders. So Prophet ﷺ covered his shoulders when he was praying. He didn't pray, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, showing his shoulders. So shoulders, awrah, is it wajib or sunnah? That's another case. We want to give a lecture to discuss this issue in detail. Second hadith, Sahih Muslim, عن أم هاني هو ناس أم هاني هو ناس أم هاني أم هاني is the sister of علي بن أبي طالب أم هاني is the sister of علي بن أبي طالب and her hadith came the time of the conquest of Mecca she lived in Mecca and when Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم came yeah, فتح مكة yeah. He went to her house and then he had shower, he had bath. He had bath. And then he prayed sunnah. Yeah. And then she came to him and said, Oh Prophet of Allah, there's two men related to my husband. Yeah. Not Muslims. Yeah. I gave them protection. And my brother came. Yeah, I said she will kill them. So Prophet says, the famous hadith of Umm Hani, قَدْ أَجَرْنَا مَنْ أَجَرْتِ يَا أُمُّ هَانِ Umm Hani will give protection to whom you gave protection to. Yeah. So that's the famous hadith of Umm Hani. In here, Umm Hani said, أَنَّ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ صَلَّى فِي بَيْتِهَا He prayed in her house. Yeah. He prayed in her house. Observed prayer. In her house. Aam al-Fath on the day of conquest of Mecca. So how many Prophet ﷺ prayed? Yeah. She said, 8 rak'ah of prayer. 8 rak'ah. Is that duha or is that yeah, thanks to Allah for the conquest of Mecca? Duha is from 2 to 8. From 2 rak'ah to 8 rak'ah. Even. And Prophet ﷺ mostly he prayed 4. But in here he prayed 8 rak'ah. She said, في ثوب in one garment. He prayed in one garment. What he done? قد خالف بين طرفيه. He put opposite sides of the to the shoulder. So the side, the corner side of the right side, he put on the left corner, left shoulder, and the one of the left side, he put on the right shoulder, and then he tied it at the back. To hold it. That means Prophet ﷺ used to pray, yeah, covering his shoulders. That's the sunnah, action of the Prophet. When it comes to the command, متفق عليه, حديث أكيد أبون, أن أبي هريرة قال, قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, لا يسلين أحدكم. One of you should not pray في ثوب الواحد. in single garment, without prayer. ليس على عاتقيه شيء. And it doesn't cover, it doesn't put any only of it or only part of that garment on his shoulders. So the hadith is commanding. Scholars disagreed, is that command wajib or not? But there's another hadith in Jabir, when Abdullah was old and blind, he led Salah at home in his house with some companions. All his clothes was one side and used one garment without covering his shoulders. So that's the action of the companion. Can the action of the companion be same like the saying of the Prophet ﷺ? No. So Al-Albani says it's going to be wajib to cover the shoulders. Jumhur ulama say it's sunnah. Inshallah, in detail is in the lecture of the garments or brain the garments. Rest of our book, we are talking about awratul mar'ati fi salah. Awratul mar'ati fi salah. The part, the private parts of the female in the salah. Abu Dawud narrated an Aisha an Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam annahu qala لا يقبل الله Allah does not accept salata the prayer of حائضين the woman who reached the menstruation إلا بخمار except covering her head and neck head and the neck something covering Unless she wears that, her salah not accepted. Sharh al-Mumti' Ibn Uthaymeen said, فَشَعْرُهَا هَهَا وَجَمِيعِ جِسْمُهَا and all her body عَوْرَةٌ يَجِبُ عَلَيْهَا أَن تَسْتُرُهَا يَجِبُ عَلَيْهَا أَن تَسْتُرُهَا It is wajib upon her to cover. ما عدا الوجه والكفين فإذا فعلت ذلك فقد تم صلاتها باتفاق consensus of the scholars that her salah is perfect when she does that some scholars they believe face is awra should be covered but in the salah should she show her face and kafein her hands and the palm until his, but they say if there's a strange woman, she should cover and pray. Those scholars who say covering face is sunnah, she should take off the cover of the face when she's praying. We want to talk about this issue also in details. And niqab, is it wajib or not? And Al-Albani, he done a book discussing this issue. Now, we want to see awratul mar'ati ma'al akharina. What is the private parts of the female in front of others? In front of others, divided to three. Husband, related, and non-related. Husband, there's no awra. We don't discuss that. We discuss about the other people. In here, we divide it into two parts, men and women. What's her aura in front of the men? What's her aura in front of the woman? Men, we divide into two, mahram and non-mahram. Mahram has certain way, certain parts they can see, and certain way dealing with non-mahram. It comes to women, Muslim women, and non-Muslim women. Some people think non-Muslim women can see whatever from a Muslim woman. No. In here, if you notice the colors, mahram and Muslim woman are same category. Non-mahram and non-Muslim woman, they are same in the category. Women should cover in front of the non-Muslim woman as she covers from non-mahram men. This point, you have to understand deeply. It doesn't mean men and women only. It means women themselves, are they Muslims or not? The Muslim woman can see from any sister as her dad sees from her, or her brother. The non-Muslim woman, the Muslim woman should cover from them as they cover from other men outside. She should wear jilbab in front of them. And I hear some women Muslims, they go to swimming. Swimming, why are you swimming? They say, there's only women, and the coach is woman. The survivor, whatever supervisor, is a woman. But you allow her to show parts of her body in front of non-Muslims. They don't know that. And then there's cameras. Who is sitting behind the camera and watching? So it's not easy. It's not something simple. All this, we are going to the Adilla evidences. We are going to Adilla. مع رجال الأجانب والكافرات. Non-mahram men and disbelievers women. We need evidence. قال تعالى على سيد. We stop here, inshallah, evidence. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه. ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين.